it moves less than 1 mile an hour. So if you're heading onto it, I have to say, I think it's brilliant. Some people said it was a London eyesore, but you always get miserable so-and-sos in every walk of life. These days they spend all day on the internet, don't they? Moaning about everything, complaining and ridiculing and criticising, and get a life is what they need to do. They're the kind of people we should put on the London Eye, get them to the top and just push the button that says stop for about a couple of days, and then just, you know, throw things at them. But it's fantastic. The London Eye is fantastic. It really is an amazing addition to our skyline. You're up there for about 35 minutes. And even though it's pretty gloomy today, you'd still see about 15 to 20 miles in every direction, so it can't be bad. And you get views that are kind of unexpected. For example, when you look at Buckingham Palace, you soon realise that when it was built, they landscaped the park. The first group we picked up, if you go over to Kensington Palace and put your back to the palace, you can see straight through the 700 acre park. So you can't have a palace without landscaped gardens. Everything is geared towards, and you get that from Buckingham Palace. You know that famous balcony? We always get asked that question, is this where they have the kiss? Yes, that wonderful kiss. I thought I couldn't last to that moment. It was just so exciting. They look like two little woodpeckers having a little peck. I thought, blimey, just give her a proper snog, mate. You're married now, what's up with you? A little peck, that's pathetic. So, when they stand on the balcony, apparently, we only have their word for it, they can see straight through St. James's Park. Now, for those of you just joining us, what I always like to do is just do a little kind of resume of London's history, which crossing the bridge we're about to cross is perfect, because Waterloo Bridge is the longest and widest bridge, and it has the best views of London's history. Now, before we do that, just shortly to the left, I don't know if you want to pick up the... Just to the left, folks, have a look just through these two buildings here. You've got an iconic view that's become London Eye and Big Ben. See that sharp left? Just there through the London Eye. That's become quite iconic. It's pretty cool, isn't it, actually? I quite like that. But let's go to the right, because here is the original city of London. You've got St. Paul's Cathedral down to the right-hand side. That you can't miss, because if you can't see it, have you heard about this law? It's called the St. Paul's Grid. You can't build something that blocks out the view of that dome. All around the 630 square miles. So those of you that have read in depth about World War II, I'm guessing you've read about this dome. It became the symbol of defiance. All the buildings behind it are the City of London, but notice they're not very high-rise. So just before St. Paul's, past the high-rise, that's the City of London. That's the one the Romans came into 2,000 years ago. And in true Roman style, they built a wall around it and called it Londinium. The Celts were there, they called it Linden, but they were tribal, it was open. The Romans gave us civilization. I would imagine people were quite happy, personally, before the Romans turned up, but anyway, they civilized us, God bless them, and showed us how to live our lives correctly. Well, not before they'd finished murdering and pillaging and raping, I understand, and burning and scorching, but anyway, eventually, they showed us how to live our lives. Now, Romans did build cities. They learnt from the Greeks, they built cities. And that was the original city of London, half a square mile. But what happened in 1666 that changed London, that city burned down, 80%. If you've ever read about London, they always talk about the Great Fire of London. When that burned down, people with money moved west to this open land as it was, where they built the big new fine houses with lots of land. People without money, the majority, moved across the river and to East London. And that's where I was last night with a group of 20 trying to discover who Jack the Ripper is. Well, they never find out, will they? But that seems to be just fine. Now, this is the Strand. To the left-hand side, we have the Savoy Hotel. Just see through the gap there to the left-hand side. That's the Savoy. And the Savoy is London's premier hotel. Because what it was the first hotel in Europe to have electricity. So people paid an absolute fortune to stay there. The general manager, you'll recognise the name, was called Cesar Ritz, so I'm sure you can guess the rest of the story, right? Now, to stay there, as I say, was a privilege. And then this area started to get built up alongside. But the name, the Strand, is a Viking name for shoreline. Because as we came across that bridge, that used to be a Viking port around the year 600 to 700. If we had Romans for 400 years, when they left, they created what the historians would call a vacuum. Who filled the vacuum? The Vikings, the Angles, the Saxons. They fought amongst themselves. The Vikings took the north of the country, they conquered part of London, they never got further south. Had they done so, we certainly would not be speaking English, which is quite a good point, isn't it? We have a Scandinavian language. They were probably defeated by a man called Alfred, and he probably united what became Angleland or England. Well, that's a little kind of history for you folks. Westminster, this city, two buildings, we're going to go back down and see them. Those we just picked up, you're staying opposite those buildings that are old. Houses of Parliament, Westminster Abbey, everything else is pretty modern inside this city. Now, we always get a bit of traffic along the Strand, because it's bringing us down to where we have Trafalgar Square. You've noticed, I'm sure, there's quite a few theatres along here. And did I see right, the Bodyguard is opening? Good grief, I thought that was on years ago. Dear me. Anyway, don't put me down for that one. Thank you very much.